not sure that will happen if that doesn't happen. Is there somebody else besides him that you'd like to fight?
Absolutely. I want Daniel Geale to fight. It's my big fan of Miguel because for me very important for the best middleweight division. One city. Or no Miguel, maybe Salomon. And IBF champion from Australia.
Tom, how realistic your following unification about next?
Well, again, it's Gennady wants to prove that he's the best middleweight champion. The only way to do that is to fight the other champions. So we would go out and try to make a Sam Salomon fight if it's possible. We can't force anyone to get in the ring. We saw that with the Chavez fight. We agreed to a lot of different conditions to get the Chavez fight. It didn't happen. But, you know, Daniel Geale was a tremendous event here in Madison Square Garden. So to answer your question, that would be one of the goals. If we can't get, I think Abel would agree. That Cotto would be at the top of the list right now. Chavez is at the top of Abel's list, but as far as Miguel Cotto being the WBC middleweight champion, I think a fight between Miguel Cotto and Gennady Golovkin at the big arena here at Madison Square Garden, there's no bigger fight that can be made right now in New York City, and that would be at the top of the list for me.
I'm ready for a lucky punch. Good left hook. It's a good decision.
Just to expand on that, there's no question about Gennady's punching power, but there's also, I think after tonight, no question about his chin. He was in with one of the biggest punchers, Curtis Stevens, in the middleweight division, and didn't get affected, and after Daniel valiantly and bravely threw a big punch, and Gennady countered it, and there's just nobody that can stand up to his punching power, but it also shows what kind of punch he can take and is willing to take to put on an exciting and impressive performance. And that's really what Abel has instilled with him, is not to outbox someone, but really take the fight to him and do whatever he can. Not to look for the knockout, but the way Gennady fights just creates the knockout.
Yes, hi.
That was a
question. I know I was prepared for his style of fighting. Man, did he show you anything? Did he surprise you at all? Pretty much expected. Did he surprise you all in the lane?
No, just first round. I look his tactics, strategy. No, just second round is my job.
Vertical. We have a wireless microphone now, so this will be a lot easier with that. Once you turn it on.
Question for Abel Sanchez. Abel, could you give a grade to Gennady and also your assessment of his performance?
I would have to give him about a 9. Only because I was asking him in between the first and the second round, between the second and third round, to stop searching for a shot. Stop looking for his head. I wanted him to go to the body a little more, to the shoulders, and that shot would come. But he was hell-bent on trying to knock him out early, and he wasn't listening. He did what he thought was best in there, and he's the one that's in there, so all we can do is ask from the outside.
Were you surprised by the fan turnout today? And did that do you motivate you at all?
Not a big surprise for me, just not. I think my fans and all people, he understand boxing. He love it. Style, like my style, like Mexican style, just fight. It's not boxing, it's fight. You know, it's not game, it's fight. I think people love this style. It's kind of great. It's very good for me, for everybody.
Gennady, you are one of the rising superstars of boxing, and in part, it's thanks to the Latino community. We love you. And We were all salivating at the fight that was about to happen between you and Chavez. I understand that there's a lot of things that you cannot manipulate, but how did you feel about not fighting Chavez?
Thank you. No, just this question is not for me. I'm ready, Hannibal. And I want this fight. I need this fight. Just I understand my situation. Just maybe I need time. A great show, the biggest fight. Not just time.
I think just to add to what Gennady's saying, that's really more of a question for Chavez. I know Bob Arum put a big guarantee in front of him. Also put a guarantee in case he lost. And Chavez didn't sign the contract, so we don't know all the intricacies of that promotional deal. We know there was a lot of money on that table, and when he says it's not his time, what he means is he can't force the fight to happen. I can't force the fight to happen. The other fighter has to sign the contract. And so what he means by saying that is just he's going to go step by step. Chavez won't fight, sign, but won't fight. We have the commitment from HBO. That, and I could probably, where's Peter Nelson? Maybe I'll let him announce it. Anyway, we have a renewed commitment from HBO that they're going to keep him very active, give him dates. I mean, how can you not? It was my prediction before the fight, and I stand by it, that this will be the highest rated show of any boxing show here in America. And that's a tribute to somebody from Kazakhstan living in Germany, training in Big Bear, and it's only been less than 2 years to fight here. And it's just the way, the excitement that he brings to the ring, and the fans seeing that he's willing to fight anyone. We can't force him to fight, but that's what the fans appreciate. And it's kind of the Mike Tyson effect in America here that Gennady's bringing to the middleweight division.
What is the timetable for his next fight?
The next fight would be in October or November.
For Gennady and for Gable, obviously you say you like the big punch, the knockout punch.
How critical is your technical ability to setting it up, the way you cut off the ring and the way you jab.
No, I'll show you next time. Just give me a big fight, big name, I'll show you my technique. This way. No.
Eddie, congratulations, first time in Big Garden. Tom, this question is for you. Did you expect to have the turnout that you did to have the big crowd?
We worked closely with Madison Square Garden. I really have to take my hats off to the whole staff there. Joel Fisher, Adam Thier, Sal Federico. They really provided a platform for us to rely on. And when we first talked about Gennady fighting Geale and with the heavyweight co-feature, we realized it was too big to take to the theater. And the Chavez fight was gonna happen at the Forum, which is owned by MSG and renovated by MSG. And so the decision was made. We'll go into the big arena. This will be his first fight here. We scaled it for 9,000. Bernie, I think the official count was 8,572? Is that correct? So we came close to the mark that we scaled it for. We closed off the upper bowl. But it was still an electric. It was clearly too big for the theater, and it was a big energy in the arena. And every time he fights, last time he doubled, basically, just like his HBO ratings, double-digit increases every time he fights. He doubled the amount of attendance from the last fight against Curtis Eves in the theater to this fight in the arena. And it's a step-by-step process. I mean, again, he's been less than 2 years in America, but there's a lot of exciting things to come. And when people ask me how good he is, we're only going to find out how good he is when he fights what's perceived as the best competition, and right now Daniel Geale is clearly his best competitor.
The market right now is kind of flooded with pay-per-views, some deserving, some not. Is there any rush to get him on pay-per-view?
There's no rush. The only way it makes sense to do a pay-per-view is if he has a pay-per-view opponent. And I think there's three clearly out there. It's Canelo, it's Cotto, Chavez. Mayweather is a little bit unrealistic, and Gennady's never called out Floyd. It's just when people ask, would he come down to 154 and fight Floyd? The answer is yes, but that's not calling him out because Floyd fights in a lower division.
Right.
But those are the realistic pay-per-views. Anyone else, Gennady's happy to fight on HBO, and we think he reaches a broader audience. When we're building his star and building his cachet, we're happy to continue to build that until he gets to a point where there's a competitive match that, that people are going to be worth willing to pay for.
Well, if this fight, if none of those middleweight opponents, those fights can't happen, or for some reason they don't happen, would he consider going up to 168 to fight a competitive fight against Andre Ward?
That, you know, that that's a fight that's going to be tough to make, only because of the financial situation. You know, it's Gennady would go to 168. Carl Froch sold 80,000 tickets in the Wembley Stadium. I mean, that's a testament to his marketability. Chavez is a proven pay-per-view star. Andre Ward is a terrific fighter. I've answered this question a number of times before, and we have a lot of respect. Everyone at the table has a lot of respect for his boxing ability. But the finances for that fight doesn't make sense for Gennady to go up to 168 when there's so many big names at 160, and Andre's going to want a big chunk of that money. And for Gennady to move up, he's going to want a big chunk of the money, just like he was going to get to fight Chavez. That was a pay-per-view financial structure, and the money was there to make that fight.
Well, just to your right, Tom, if it were Solomon, any chance the fight's in Australia? If not, where would it be?
Sam Solomon, actually, I had discussions with him before the fight, and there was interest in unifying the titles. HBO would show that fight as a unification fight. And I think it would make sense, just like Geale fought him here, Solomon would fight him here, and it'd be on pay-per-view in Australia, and I think that would be a big event. In the U.S., when I say here, I mean the U.S. I mean, the Garden has become our first choice, but you know, they're very busy in the fall. They have the Knicks scheduled again, and the Rangers starting up, so they're very busy on Saturday nights in the fall, so if it can't be in the big arena, we would find a different location, and we really want to branch out. I mean, he trains in L.A., and he gets mobbed by a lot of the fans when he goes to the fights there in L.A. And also Vegas is a market that's very interested in hosting Gennady. So we want to develop him in all the different cities. But New York is clearly the media capital, and that's part of the reasons why he's been so successful.
Tom, another question. I think you just kind of answered it, but with playing on with Gennady, he's saying he has a Mexican style, trained by a Mexican-American, trains in Big Bear. What would be the likelihood that you would find a fight at the Forum, even at the Staples Center?
I think that depends on the opponent, and with the right type of opponent, I think the Staples Center would be a terrific venue. The Forum would be a terrific venue. The Chavez fight, you know, even when it was rumored to be out there, we got a tremendous response, and I think that would have sold out at the Forum. With that, you know, there's a lot of Russian speaking. Residents, and when we did the Klitschko fights, when Vitaly fought at Staples Center, when he fought Lennox Lewis, and when he fought Corey Sanders, when he fought Chris Areola, I mean, we had a big turnout at Staples Center. So we feel that that would be a great, Gennady would be a great star in LA. We just need the right opponent to make it make sense.
Anyone?
Gennady, this question is for you. You obviously had the stars aligned tonight. A lot of the names you consider casual boxing fans. You have Donald Trump, Michael J. Fox. How does it feel to bring these type of names out here, come to see you?
Just everybody can be looking at my face. Smiling every time. Thank you for me. And not just for me, just for my team. Thank you very much for my team. Great job. And big day for me. Thank you.
We'll conclude the press conference with that. It's getting late for Gennady. Just wanted to thank everyone. I want to thank Max, his twin brother, Abel Sanchez again. Max Herman is the manager, Oleg Herman, and obviously Gennady has just taken his career to another level tonight. So we want to thank everyone for coming out and being here.